everybody. I'm here with Alistair from Rule and Make, and we are checking out the state of Hand of Fate, the board game, which is based on one of my absolute favorite video games. So I'm super, super excited to see how this is doing. So how's it going?
Yeah, good. Yeah, thanks for coming by.
Oh, our pleasure, our pleasure. Like I say, this is based on one of my favorite properties, so I'm super psyched.
Awesome, yeah, yeah. Yeah, it's a full partnership between Defiant Development, who are the creators of the Hand of Fate universe, and ourselves. This is Hand of Fate Ordeals, and it sits in between Hand of Fate 1 and Hand of Fate 2. At its core, it's a deck builder with an adventuring element, and we draw inspiration from the Hand of Fate video game to try and simulate some of the style of gameplay that you'd get out of the video game, but in the board game space. So it's a completely from the ground up implementation with a very talented designer, local designer, Barantis, and we're really happy with where it's at.
I mean, some of the art looks absolutely phenomenal. Love the art direction in the source material, and it's cool to see how you've translated that to real cards and real components.
In fact, a lot of this artwork is brand new art done by Jesse, who is the artist on the original Hand of Fate. This very iconic line art, lithographic style of art. And in addition to that, the very talented Ian O'Toole, who's working on games such as Lisboa and The Gallerist, fairly prolific, two very talented artists who have brought this to life.
So what's the real core gameplay experience for Hand of Fate Ordeals?
So the core gameplay, so deck building at its heart. So you have your character board, and every player is represented with a unique miniature. This is just the demo low-res version. We've got the pretty ones over there.
We're going to show you the pretty ones.
So everyone gets a unique miniature. It's your deck building to improve your character, and at the same time, you're moving around the central area, trying to find the royal for that level. Starts with the jack, then once the jack is defeated, you proceed to the queen. So we've got the jack here. Once the jack is defeated, the queen comes out, and then finally the king. Each level is progressively harder, so players are forced to improve their character, and they're forced to do deck build. They can't just kind of wing it all the way through.
Gotcha.
Maybe for the first level they can kind of fudge their way through a little bit, but they'll get punished in the second level if they don't pay attention to their character.
One of the best things about the game is that sort of emergent gameplay experience of never quite knowing what's around the next corner, and it seems like you've tried to capture that in the board game experience. Are there a lot of like unique encounters and things for players to run into?
Yeah, definitely. So each level is set up with the seven encounters plus the royal. So I know where the jack is because I set this up myself.
Convenient.
So there's the jack there. So as players move around, they spend food to move, they move to encounters, they flip it over, and then things happen. So for instance, this is a combat, they would fight two minions. Minions come out of the minion deck, and they follow the suits of the game. Scale, dust, plague, and skull. Mm-hmm. Various toughness to the minions. So they don't really know what they're going to encounter. So there might be nice stuff, like the bustling marketplace, which makes things cheaper. Could be more enemies, mm-hmm. or they could bump into the jack.
Right.
And if they bump into the jack, they have to fight the jack. There's no choice. The other cards in the jack level, they can go, oh, you know what, this isn't for me, I'm going to move on.
Right.
But then as levels get tougher and tougher, there's more and more of those ambush cards. So again, they're not really sure what's out there, mm-hmm. and they're running the risk of coming across something and being forced to encounter it when they're not really ready.
The deck building component, that's building out your equipment. Also blessings from like from the video game, or
somewhat it's so it draws the inspiration from the video game. Mm-hmm. It's not a direct sort of one-to-one.
Yeah.
So there's three main archetypes in the game. There's the Wanderer, which is the likes to get out there, they generate a lot of food, they draw more cards to get more food, mm-hmm. and they tend to have a lot of resilience, so they can fight lots and lots of minions. Soldier cards, which are more about lots and lots of attacks, they like to build up attacks on their weapons and then just unleash fury upon their enemies. And trickster cards, which are all about deck manipulation, so drawing cards to discard cards, to draw more cards, to destroy cards, you know, deck thinning and manipulation. And then there's equipment as well. So players are trying to gather equipment and better actions for their deck, which they draw to their hand, which they can play during their turn. So they're building up on their boards. As they get armor would go onto their player board. As they get better weapons, they start replacing weapons on their board.
Sure.
And then as they get attacks, they're going to start building up attacks on their weapon. So when they fight minions, they then unleash their attacks upon that minion. So it's all about getting battle ready and getting psyched up, ready to go in there and start punching things.
Building yourself up and then taking on the royal.
Yeah, definitely.
That's very cool. It's interesting because I'm kind of glad to see that it's got a life of its own and it's not just an attempt at a direct port. So that's really cool.
Definitely.
Really neat.
Yeah.
How's the I know that you had a really successful Kickstarter, like mm-hmm. tremendously so. How's the process going? Things smooth so far?
Yeah, really good. The base game is done, so everything's locked down for the base game.
That's awesome.
And now we're just working on the additional content for the royalty expansion, which includes the co-op scenarios. So the base game is 2-4 player competitive, mm-hmm. but it's non-adversarial. You're not fighting each other.
Right.
You're just going out there as fast as you can to find stuff. But there is a co-op mode, and the expansion will include additional scenarios for the other royals. So we're just working on that at the moment, and then finalizing the rulebook layouts and all that sort of last sort of stuff that can get...
Can always use another pass.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Yeah.
It's done when it's done kind of thing.
Pretty much.
Well, I'm really excited to see where this is going. Thank you so much for giving us a quick walkthrough of it.
Thanks for coming by.
Hey there. Thanks for watching. If you want to see more videos like this, give us a like and hit that subscribe button. And we'll see you next game.